السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Good morning guys. Welcome to our lesson today. We will study lesson 8 reading page 26 and 27. Before we listen and read this text, let's answer these two questions first. What do you know about Sheikh Sulaiman Al-Rajhi? Sheikh Sulaiman Al-Rajhi is a great philanthropist and a very successful businessman and billionaire who introduced Islamic banking into the world. Where do you think this photo was taken? Look at this photo. Where do you think this photo was taken? It was probably during an interview or awards ceremony. Awards ceremony, لي حفل التكريم. And which words are used to describe Sulaiman Al-Rajhi? World renowned philanthropist. Renowned means known, respected and admired, as we said in the vocabulary lesson. Billionaire, successful businessman, dedicated, committed to. Okay, committed to his work, of course. Okay, guys. Now we will listen to the text, then we will answer some questions after listening. Listen carefully.
Sheikh Sulaiman bin Abdul Aziz Al-Rajhi. Sheikh Sulaiman bin Abdul Aziz Al-Rajhi, the world-renowned philanthropist and winner of the 2012 King Faisal International Prize for Service to Islam, has not always been a billionaire. Born in 1920, he spent his youth in Al-Qasim, where he and his brother Saleh began their business changing money for pilgrims on their way to the cities of Makkah and Medina. Their business expanded in the 1970s during the oil boom in Saudi Arabia. The Al-Rajhi brothers helped migrant workers from Indonesia, Pakistan, and other places to send their earnings home. They were granted permission to establish a bank, the Al-Rajhi Bank, which complied with religious tenets such as a ban on interest. Founding the bank, which is now the world's biggest Islamic lender, was not hurdle-free. Sulaiman Al-Rajhi began by opening an office in Britain to introduce the Islamic banking system on a more international basis. However, his initial attempts to secure a banking license were unsuccessful, as British officials were not aware of the principles and requirements of Islamic banking. He had to travel to different countries in order to explain to bankers that interest was forbidden by Islam and regarded as unacceptable by pious people all over the world. He pointed out that interest caused a lot of people to avoid transactions with banks and to keep their cash and valuables at home. Eventually, the banking system he proposed was launched in Saudi Arabia and subsequently implemented in the United Kingdom. Sheikh Sulaiman bin Abdul Aziz Al-Rajhi is also chairman of the National Agricultural Development Company and founder of the Al-Wataniya Agricultural Projects, which include the largest poultry farm in the Middle East and one of the most successful companies in Saudi Arabia. Al-Rajhi had visited a poultry farm abroad and had been shocked by the improper way chickens were fed and slaughtered. This prompted him to launch the poultry farm project, making sure that chickens were naturally fed and halal slaughtered according to Islamic tenets. He has also introduced and supported organic farming throughout the Middle East, intent on securing healthy food for all as a means of fostering good health, preventing illness, and consequently reducing the cost of medical treatment. The Al-Rajhi projects diversified into other areas as well, such as real estate and other investment projects. In 2009, Sulaiman Al-Rajhi established the Sulaiman Al-Rajhi University, a non-profit research university with three departments, medicine, nursing, and applied science. In fact, the university was established by Sulaiman Al-Rajhi Charitable Foundation, SAAR, which is considered the largest foundation of its kind in the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, in terms of capital as well as range and volume of activities. SAAR now owns and controls more than half of Sulaiman al-Raji's wealth. The foundation organizes and oversees a substantial number of charities and humanitarian activities worldwide. In May 2011, Sulaiman al-Raji announced that he was donating most of his $7.7 billion fortune to charity. It is not uncommon for people in the Islamic world to set aside one-third or one-fourth of their wealth for endowment, effective after death. In Sulaiman al-Raji's case, however, this was implemented during his lifetime. He distributed the rest of his wealth to his children in order to avoid potential disputes over inheritance that could destroy kinship and harmony among them.
Sulaiman al-Raji was awarded the highly prestigious King Faisal International Prize for the Service to Islam in 2012. In recognition of his outstanding service to Islam, his role in the establishment of the world's largest Islamic bank, and his ongoing contribution to charities, humanitarian projects fight against poverty. Having experienced extreme poverty earlier in life, he chose to donate and distribute all his assets, becoming poor once again, but gaining peace of mind and inner happiness. Despite his advanced age, he enjoys a fully active life as he travels to various regions of the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, managing the endowment project under his flagship, the SAAR Foundation.
Okay, the first questions here. Which were the main characteristics of the Al-Rajhi Bank? From the first two or three paragraphs, you can find the answer here in these paragraphs. Which were the main characteristics of the Al-Rajhi Bank? Characteristics means features, للمميزات. It complied with the tenets of Islam, such as a ban of interest. Okay, this is one of the most characteristics of Al-Rajhi Bank, that it deals with no interest. Okay, the word boom here, their business expanded in the 1917 during the oil boom. يعني التجارة بتاعته أو العمل التجاري بتاعه امتد في 1970 during the oil boom. Boom here means advance, اللي هو في أثناء ازدهار أو تقدم in Saudi Arabia. The Al-Rajhi brothers helped migrant workers اللي هم العمال اللي بيسافروا أو بالهجروا from Indonesia, Pakistan and other places to send their earnings home, to send their money earned home. They were granted permissions to establish a bank, to build a bank, the Al-Rajhi Bank, which complied with religious tenets. Complied means meets the religious tenets, يعني ينسجم أو يتفق مع الشريعة الإسلامية أو العقيدة الإسلامية, such as a ban on interest, زي مثلا تحريم ban اللي هو تحريم on interest. Interest هنا معناها الفوائد وليست الاهتمامات. Okay, another question. What does the writer say about the process of founding the first Islamic bank? It was not hurdle free. As mentioned here, founding the bank, which is now the world's biggest Islamic lender, was not hurdle free. This is the answer, okay, about the first Islamic bank. Okay, another question. Was the banking system that Al-Rajhi suggested launched for the first time in the UK? Yes or no? Okay, Muhab?
No, Saudi Arabia.
Yes, very good. Thank you, Muhab. No, it was launched in Saudi Arabia and then implemented in the UK. Okay, as mentioned here. Okay, founding the bank, which is now the world's biggest Islamic lender, was not hurdle-free. Sulaiman al-Rajhi began by opening an office in Britain to introduce the Islamic banking system on a more international basis. However, his initial attempts to secure a banking license were unsuccessful, as British officials were not aware of the principles and requirements of Islamic banking. يعني ما كانوش على دراية بالمبادئ والأساسيات والمتطلبات حق البنك الإسلامي في بريطانيا. He had to travel to different countries in order to explain to bankers that interest was forbidden by Islam and regarded as unacceptable by pious people. طبعا اضطر انه يسافر لدول مختلفة عشان يقنعهم ويشرح لهم ان الفوائد محرمة في الدين الإسلامي and regarded as unacceptable. وبينظر إليها على إنها unacceptable غير مرغوب فيها by pious people. Pious people means religious people, نوع المتدينين يعني. All over the world. He pointed out that interest caused a lot of people to avoid transaction. Transactions means business deal, اللي هو التعاملات with banks. يعني الفوائد دي بتخلي ناس كتير يرفضوا التعامل مع البنك بسبب الفوائد. And to keep their cash and valuables at home. Eventually, at the end, the banking system he proposed was launched in Saudi Arabia. يبقى أول بنك إسلامي، نظام إسلامي، تم إنشاءه أو تم العمل به في السعودية and subsequently implemented in the United Kingdom. بعد كده تم تطبيقه in United Kingdom في المملكة المتحدة. بعد ما كانوا رافضين في الأول. Okay, next question. What is the role of Sheikh Sulaiman bin Abdul Aziz al-Rajhi in the Al-Wataniya Agriculture Projects? Of course, he was the founder of Al-Wataniya. He was the founder. هو المؤسس, as mentioned here. Okay, next question. Why was Sheikh Sulaiman bin Abdul Aziz al-Rajhi shocked when he visited a poultry farm abroad? A poultry farm means the farm for chickens, اللي مزارع الدواجن. Why he was shocked? By the improper way chickens were fed and slaughtered. يعني بالطريقة اللي بيتم بيها إطعام الدواجن وذبحهم. دي طبعا سببت له shocked يعني صدمة. Okay. As mentioned here, Sheikh Sulaiman bin Abdul Aziz al-Rajhi is also chairman. Chairman means president or leader of the National Agriculture Development Company and founder of the Al-Wataniya Agriculture Projects, which include the largest poultry farm. Poultry farm means a farm for chickens, اللي مزرعة دواجن, in the Middle East and one of the most successful companies in Saudi Arabia. ومن أكبر المزارع في الشرق الأوسط وأحد أنجح الشركات في السعودية. الرجحي has visited a poultry farm abroad and had been shocked by the improper way chicken were fed and slaughtered. This prompted him means urged him, يعني حثه أو دفعه, to launch the poultry farm project, making sure that chickens were naturally fed and halal slaughtered according to Islam tenets. ده خلاه making sure that chickens were naturally fed. خلاه راح هنا حسوا ان هو يبدأ المشروع الدواجن والتأكيد على الـ natural fit, الطعام الطبيعي للدواجن والذبح الحلال للدواجن طبقا للشريعة والعقيدة الإسلامية. He has also introduced and supported organic farming throughout the Middle East, intent on securing healthy food for all as a means of fostering. يعني كان بيهدف إلى أو بينوي إلى securing healthy food, لو حماية الطعام الصحي أو تأمين الطعام الصحي for all as a means للجميع كوسيلة of fostering food health كتعزيز للصحة الكويسة preventing illness and consequently reducing the cost of medical treatment والعمل على reducing يعني تقليل the cost of medical treatment اللي هو العناية أو العلاج الطبي تكلفة العلاج الطبي the الرجح projects diversified into other areas diversified means expand into other areas لمناطق كتير as well such as real estate and other investment projects this paragraph why did he distribute the rest of his wealth to his children during the lifetime can you answer this question yes Tara
To avoid the potential disputes over inheritance.
Yeah, very good. Thank you, Tore. Of course, in order to avoid disputes over inheritance. Yes, thank you, Tore. And another question here. How did he gain peace of mind and inner happiness? By distributing. Distributing means dividing his assets. لكل ممتلكاته and becoming poor once again. Okay. وزع كل ممتلكاته عشان يكسب peace of mind. Peace of mind اللي راحت البال والنير and happiness السعادة. As mentioned here, سليمان الرجحي was awarded the highly prestigious King Faisal International Prize for Service to Islam in 2012. Or 2012, in recognition of, thanks for his outstanding, كتقدير لهيز outstanding service, لخدماته البارزة والظاهرة to Islam. His role in the establishment of the world's largest Islamic bank and his ongoing contribution to charities, ومساهماته في الجمعيات والمؤسسات. And humanitarian projects fight against poverty. ومشروعاته الإنسانية اللي كانت بتحارب الفقر. Having experienced extremely poverty earlier in life, ونظرا للتجربة اللي مر بيها ببداية حياته, poverty يعني الفقر في بداية حياته, الرجحي chose to donate and distribute all his assets. عشان كده قرر ان هو او اختار ان هو يتبرع ويوزع كل ثروته وممتلكاته to gain peace of mind and inner happiness عشان يحصل على راحة البال والسعادة. Okay guys, now let's answer the first question here after reading. What were سليمان الرجحي's life prospects in relation to his early life? He didn't seem to have much hope of becoming a billionaire. يعني ما كانش عنده أمل كتير جدا إن هو يصبح بهذا الشكل بليونير. Okay. ديت في بداية حياته طبعا. كانش يحلم إن هو يكون بليونير. Question number two. What type of companies has he been involved in? Okay, Ziad.
Chicken company.
Chicken. Companies, yes. Thank you, Ziad. Banking, agriculture development, organic farming, real estate, investment, health, and more. Okay, as you said, chickens or poultry farm, مزارع الدواجن وهكذا. Okay. Number three, which business was the most difficult to establish and why? Islamic banking in the UK because British officials were not aware of the principles and requirements of Islamic banking. طبعا الموظفين في بريطانيا ما كانوش يعرفهم the principles and requirements المبادئ والمتطلبات للبنك الإسلامي فرفضوا في البداية. Okay. Number four. What is notable about سليمان الرجحي in relation with other wealthy businessmen? His work and contribution to education, health, and charities worldwide through SAAR, his company, and the largest foundation of its kind in the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia. Thank you guys. I hope you enjoyed the lesson and see you next lesson. Inshallah. Goodbye.